We'll be right back. Thank you very much. It's my privilege to be here to enjoy the success of your fine teachers and fine students. I represent the John Philip Sousa Society as the Vice President and as the co-chair of the committee, and we'll talk about that co-chair in a minute, and there's an important part to that. If you ever mentioned experience, it just means I'm old. I've been doing this for a very long time. I actually did 42 years as a high school band director, and I was fortunate to, with our students, earn this award in 1994. And there's a point in telling you that as we look at how this award transpires and what it means. Since retiring 4 years ago, I've been privileged to travel literally across the country through the Sousa Foundation as the president of the National Band Association, everywhere from Florida to Maine to Alaska to California, here, all over creation. And I tell you that only because I want to emphasize that hearing all those bands, I'm not just making up something when I say to you, what you have here is special. It's not normal. It doesn't happen everywhere. It doesn't happen very many places. There are some really great bands in the country, but they're not everywhere. And I say that because it's very important that you never take it for granted. And if you don't hear anything else I say tonight, never take it for granted. Whether you're a student here, a parent of a student here, a former parent, an administrator, a person on the staff, you have to take care of it, you have to respect it, and you have to always make sure it stays alive because it is special. It doesn't happen just because you'd like it to be this way. You know they play well, you like what they do, but you're their parents, you have to like them, that's a law. But it really is spectacular, it is really unusual, and you need to make sure that it stays that way and get the support that they need for that to happen. Special guests here, and some other people who have a part in making this award possible. They make it possible because this is not about one performance. We all go compete. We all work as hard as we can to compete. We do all those kinds of things, but most of the things that happen can happen again. You can win the contest this year, and you can win it again next year. This situation is a little bit different because it's not about one performance. It's about years and years of quality work, and we'll define that a little more in a minute. The people would, Dr. Brian Fingley, please, superintendent of schools, please stand. Kathy Kudlis, director of fine arts from Plano Independent School District. George King, principal of Plano East Senior High. Would the three of you please stand and be recognized? Presentation of the flag, we'd appreciate it if you would come down and join us and be a part of that receiving of that honor. I also would like any former band student or former band parent to stand and be recognized, because again, this award takes several years to accomplish. We have any students and parents from that past year who are here. Could not do this without help. There aren't teachers that can do everything on their own and make all this happen without all the moms and dads that do all the other thing, everything from carrying water buckets on up. You have to be here, and we do appreciate your participation. This doesn't happen just because at the high school, the senior high level, a few people do work. It happens because starting from the very beginning, there are great people doing great work. Would Travis Smith, Bo Henderson from Williams High School, please stand. Chris Brown and Ryan Albert from Millen High School, please stand. This is Treadwell from Armstrong Middle School. Mark Casperson and Kelsey Dunn from Bowen Middle School. Cyber Nick Chappell from Murphy Middle School. From Otto Middle School. For all of you, it's not just to have that we call your name. It is really appreciated what you do, and having been in the same situation as this, where my wife and I worked together for all those years. If she hadn't done what she did, I'd been dead in the water. So all the people that feed the program, it is very important that you continue to do what you do. We appreciate that greatly. Going a little bit about the history of what's happening here tonight. In your program, it talks a little bit about Lewis Sudler. It talks about he was a very, very wealthy man. He made a lot of money in business. He also was a singer, a very competent singer, and sang in a lot of places and whatever. But it's a funny thing that a person who was versed in vocal music and knew almost nothing about bands is the person who funded the John Philip Sousa Society. Foundation is now a foundation because of that funding. And there's a connection there between Lewis Sudler and his wife, Virginia, and all their time in Chicago. And they happened to meet a gentleman named Al Wright and his wife, Gladys. And instead of me to go, I'm the co-chair of this committee because for a certain reason. And that reason is that Gladys Wright has been part of this particular award since its inception, a little over 30 years ago. And as long as she wants to be part of that and be co-chair of that committee, we'll let her do it forever and ever. She's 92 years old. She still comes to the convention and still is a part of everything we do. 2 weeks from now, I'm going to Indiana to Al's birthday. Al will be 100. That's pretty amazing. Gives you a little insight in the kind of support that the band movement and the people who do this have from people with inside the band movement. But again, Lewis Sudler is a singer. He knew nothing about bands, so he met Al Wright when Mal was the band director at Purdue and started asking questions about how do these people learn to do all this stuff? How do they, you know, do they all just do it on their own? Because as a singer, he largely was a self-taught person early on. And so Al started introducing to the public school music programs and started taking him to places to hear things, and he would take him to a school and bring him back to the Purdue Ant-Man. And over a period of time, he said, this is amazing. Some of these people are incredible and they're getting no credit for what they really do. What can I do to help? And at that point in time, he funded the John Philip Sousa Foundation and made it possible for the foundation to support these awards and have all these things happen. It's an interesting history and one that we respect greatly. In the program, it lists some of the original requirements for this award, the proposed requirements, and it's left in there so you can see the original proposal. It never happened quite that way because before it ever was published the first year, the people who, basically Gladys Wright, whose high school band played Midwest, and some of the things, said this is not hard enough. We need to make it more difficult. So where it says 3 years in your program and stuff like that, all that got changed to the minimum requirement is 7 years of documentation. Most of the portfolios coming through have 8, 10, and 12 years of documentation just to make sure that everybody understands what's going on and what's expected. And then in that minimum 7 years, it requires concert festival score sheets. In other words, when they get those sheets back, all those score sheets for the 7 year period, all the solo and ensemble rating sheets, all those have to be listed, every student's score through those things, district and all state participation, how many kids were in those kinds of things, lists of literature that the bands played over all those years. Things like marching band participation, things that are done through the marching band program, information about all the different aspects of the program, and letters from prominent people in the band world. And I will tell you that sometimes we get one of these applications that comes through, and it has a recommendation from the middle school band director and the principal, and the committee won't even look at it, because it says very clearly, prominent people in the band world. So the letters that are getting rewritten are by the named people around the country for people who are doing this kind of work. And the last part of that is the recording, and the recording is very specific, and I want to talk, I just need to talk about that. There must be on the recording a march, there must be an original band work, and there must be an orchestral transcription, because we feel like the marches are the history of the band, and the orchestral literature is something kids should all be exposed to and should learn about, and so it's required that those things be there. The recordings are submitted to me, and with the help of another person who's much better at computer than I am, we put them in a file, and the files are sent to the committee members. Now, there are a little over 20 people on that committee, and to put in perspective for you, everybody on the committee has won this award at some point in time. So you can guess that it's really specific to them and very personal to them that the standards stay really high, and that the award not be given to anybody that they don't think really, it's not like it's not personal, it's very close and personal. Having said that, the applications come 1st of November, and the committee meeting is toward the end of December. So the committee has the recordings for that 6-week period. What they don't have is the name of the school that's being listened to. All they have is number 1, number 6, number whatever it is on the list, and the recordings are all heard blind. And when they show up in Chicago at the Midwest for the meeting on Friday afternoon, they come in the door, and before they can sit down and talk to anybody else, they have to take the pages laying there and put their votes by every band on there. They have no discussion. They don't know who they're talking about. All they know is which recordings they really liked and which they didn't. And the voting is done right there. And the next thing that happens is all that book and those materials we talked about that have to be submitted, and the committee scrutinizes all that material to make sure it really is accurate and all the things are in there. However, they still don't know when they're looking at that book whose recording that applied to. Two totally separate pieces. And so when the decision is finally made from all the people that applied, and I can tell you this year there were bands as far east as North Carolina, and there and bands in Texas and even west of here, very good programs that were not selected. So it's and I know I'm going on about this a bit because I want to put in perspective, it's a very arduous process to get to this point. And then the last part of that, it's also once in a lifetime. We talked earlier about the possibility of winning a contest again or doing something over and over, and we should always, I would encourage every student in here to always do your very, and every time you go back, you try to do it better and do it again. But this can never happen again. And Mr. Burial is old, not like me, and decides to retire. The school cannot, since 94 when we earned it, and told the guys that took my places there for another 5 or 6 years, they can't even apply again. Even if you apply again, it'll be of a different director. So this is truly a once-in-a-lifetime situation, and for that, it deserves the kind of respect that a once-in-a-lifetime, you can't put in. So congratulations, it's been a great honor. Would the representatives of the school please come forward so we can do this presentation? Put in perspective, one last thing for you, and if you were auditioning for Allstate this year, and you were the first chairperson in Allstate, on whatever your instrument was, there are 50 kids in the country this year that can say the same thing. They're 50 first year All-State trumpet players, goes to 50 states. There are 50 state championship football teams if there was only one per state. But since there's all these divisions, there's a bunch. Over the 30 years of this award, if there's 50 a year, that means there's over 1,500 kids that can claim they were first year All-State. Our 1,500 teams that can claim they were the state champion. And over that 30 years, there's a total of 74 of those flags out of 25,000 high schools in the country. Somebody spread that out so they can see it, please. The staff, to the students, Plano East High School, Senior High School, congratulations from the John Philip Sousa Society. This is a plaque from the foundation that says Sudler Flag Honor, an international award to recognize high school concert band programs of a very highest quality. I will tell you that as soon as we finish this summer, the historic record of the best of high school bands will be published on the Sioux Foundation site, and this will now qualify families to go on that list. That list starts in the 20s with the Joliet High School Band and the Bill Rebellion's Band. It's a truly historic list of the great high school bands in the country. This award is presented to Vilio Villarreal, Director of Bands, Plano East High School, 2015.